right. How you doing? I'm Mark, and I want to welcome you to Hangin' with Mr. Cooper. What's up? Yes. All right. You know, now that I'm on television, people walk up to me and say,
my man, what's it like to be on television?
And I tell them, I say, it's live. You know why? Because on television, you can do whatever you want to do. For example, if I wanted to thunder and lightning, I could do that. Watch. Look at that. That's live, isn't it? If I want wild animals to roar, I could do that. Watch. Isn't that live? Hey, if I want a beautiful woman to come to my door, I could do that, too. Watch. Uh-oh, beautiful woman. There you go. Wait a minute before I do that. How you doing, baby?
Hey, man, so.
Hey, man. It's the ugliest woman I've ever seen in my life. I'm gonna talk to casting about that.
Hey, yo, what's up? What's my theme music?
I'm ready. Turn it out. Here we go. Here we go.
Hey, Mark.
Hey, Robin. You looked what? Tough day at school?
Yeah. First and second violin got into a knife fight. Ooh. I don't think that metal detector's working.
Man, wait a minute. I've been waiting for you, girl. What do we say we could shoot a couple of baskets and see who cooks dinner?
Oh, no.
I'll right. Shoot left-handed.
You're on.
You know I don't miss.
Left-handed,
right-handed. Where you at? Where
I'm there. Go ahead.
That was a little practice shot. I'll give you one, too. Go on.
Oh, don't even try it. Just give me the ball. Practice shot. You gonna let me shoot the ball or what?
Yeah, I just had a little phlegm in my throat. Go ahead.
The pressure's on, ladies and gentlemen. The fans are shouting brick, brick, brick. Can't you do it?
I don't know, Jim. She hasn't hit a free throw since room 222 was on.
Bang! I do like linguine. You need a shower.
You know, there's reports that she's on steroids. You know that.
Come on. You just better get dinner started.
Hey, I'm on it, all right? Let's see. Italian.
Well, Mark, you've had quite an afternoon, haven't you? When you came home, you got something from the fridge. Then you stopped by the bathroom. Then you plopped down in front of the TV.
You've been spying on me, baby girl.
Didn't have to. You left a trail of clothes the whole way.
And you picked them up? Now, how am I supposed to find my way back?
I'll get it. Mark, you took off all of those clothes?
Yeah, I like to watch Oprah naked. That way I get the bare facts.
Mark, there's someone here to see you.
Come in.
Hi, Mark.
Paula? What are you doing here?
I just moved back. I got a job anchoring the local news, and I thought I'd look you up.
Paula!
Well, now that's it. No more drinks in the living room.
I didn't realize this was gonna come as such a shock.
But you could at least called or something.
Oh, I did call. Vanessa said it would be okay to drop by.
Well, she sounded nice on the phone.
Oh, Vanessa, can I see you in the kitchen for a minute?
Sure. Robin, I hope you're not still mad at me.
Me? Now, you know I can't hold a grudge.
Good. Can I sit?
No.
What's the big deal?
The big deal is Paula is my ex-girlfriend.
Oh, she dumped you, huh?
No, the breakup was mutual, and I had the final word.
Don't leave me in there with that woman.
Why does everyone hate her so much?
Are you kidding me? After the way she dumped Mark?
Final word, huh?
Yeah, well, she said, I'm leaving. I said, okay.
Okay, Mark, please. The man was devastated, cried on my shoulder for a week. Stop.
I was not crying. At the time, I had a Jerry curl, and the juice was...
See, Paula and I used to be tight, right? And she asked me to introduce her to Mark. Mm-hmm. Then the day after he didn't make the NBA, she went and hooked up with somebody who did.
Stop.
Yeah.
Now, why do you always have to bring that up? Mark didn't make it in the NBA. You could be talking about the weather. You know, it was really hot today. It's about 100. Mm-hmm. You know Mark didn't make it in the NBA.
So anyway, when Mark didn't make it into the NBA, all of a sudden, he wasn't good enough for Miss Thing. And then she never spoke to me again. V, you just got to get rid of her.
Why me?
Because you let her in. Now, if Mark goes in there, she's just gonna smile and give him that look. And brother's gonna be putty in her hands.
Wait a minute. I'm a grown man. I got a little bit more self-control than that.
We'll go with you.
Thanks. You go first. Give me this. You don't need no weapons. Go get it. So, Paula, what is it that you want?
Oh, I just wanted to see how you were doing.
Well, I'm doing great.
Yeah, he's doing just great.
Mark, can I sit down?
Well, didn't I say no?
So, Mark, what have you been up to?
I'm a substitute teacher, and I'm proud of it. Mm-hmm. And this week, I'm teaching Mr. Jeffrey's woodshop class because he cut off his thumb. And I'm proud of that, too. And I don't care what you think.
I think that's terrific.
You do?
Putty, Mark. Putty, putty, putty.
Look, this is obviously a little awkward. Mark, why don't I give you my number? Maybe you could give me a call. We can go to lunch or something.
I don't know. I'm pretty busy with woodshop and all.
Just a thought.
Nice seeing you again, though.
Good seeing you again, too, Mark.
Okay, drive safely.
Bye.
Hey, way to be strong, my brother. But, just in case.
Hey, what you mean? I'm over her. She has no effect on the kid.
Hey, she still look good, though.
So apparently Mr. Jeffries was cutting a piece of wood just like this, and he wasn't paying attention when suddenly...
I didn't scare you guys?
Please. This is Oakland.
Oh. Okay. All right, you gotta get back to work. Let's see some finished projects or something.
Yo, here's my project.
And there's nothing but a block of wood.
No, man, see, that's where you're wrong. It's two blocks of wood glued together to make a cutting board.
Man, you've been hanging with the glue too long, man. Let's see what you got, man.
It's a cutting board.
Now, did anybody in here not make a cutting board?
I made a, doorstop.
Nice try. Look, until Mr. Jeffries gets the filling back in his thumb, I'm in charge, all right? And we are gonna do some quality work in this class. This class is not an easy A.
See ya.
Right, bring your big block here back here. First thing, I'm gonna teach you guys some practical skills that you can use in everyday life. Do you know that you could take what you learned here today and get a job out there tomorrow?
Like at a cutting board factory.
And I know you guys are creative. Look at my man here. You got to have imagination to come out the house looking like this. Mac Daddy make you. All right, you guys, remember, be creative. Use your minds, all right? Remember, a thumb is a terrible thing to waste.
Hi, Mark.
Paula, what are you doing here?
Well, you said you didn't have time to go to lunch, so I thought I'd bring lunch to you.
Paula, now I know what you're trying to do. You dogged me out. There was no excuse for that.
Mark, I was wrong.
Yeah, that's right. You were wrong.
Well, I've dated a lot of other guys since then, but none of them compared to you.
Still, it still doesn't work.
Maybe I gave up on you too soon.
Well, you did.
But I really want to be with you. It took me 3 years of therapy to realize that.
You mean I sent you to therapy? You know, you're not the first woman that I've driven crazy. You know?
You always did know how to make me laugh. Come on, have lunch with me. I made all your favorites, cornbread, yams, turkey, and guess what? Paula's pecan pie.
You made Paula's pecan pie? The one with the pecans on the bottom? No, I can't. I'm supposed to meet Robin for lunch.
Sure you can. Just a little taste.
One more nibble like that'd be just like in the drive-in. No.
They were nice. That was when we fell in love.
Yeah, how you like that cutting board? Look at that. Looks good. Good craftsmanship, huh? You can have it. Go ahead.
Remember you used to take the car? And you park it in the back, where it was real dark.
Yeah, and you would play that scared role. Remember that? Would you stop it? People can see us. At least wait till the windows are fogged up. Lights to fog those windows up.
You know, we never did see the end of Purple Rain.
He got the girl.
Hey, Mark, you ready to go to...
Robin.
I'm going to cancel lunch. Oh, forget about dinner also. Breakfast is off, too.
I just don't like what she's got him doing. It's only been a week, and she's already got him acting differently, dressing differently.
Well, I like her.
Yeah.
She's bright and articulate, goal-oriented. She reminds me a lot of me.
She's a crazy woman, okay?
Did you know she actually went to go see a shrink? There's nothing crazy about going to therapy.
Yeah, right.
Some very normal people use therapists.
V, stop.
Not you. Well, just for a little while. I had a few interpersonal conflicts to work out with my parents and some semi-obsessive behavior patterns, which I'm completely cured of. Can you see that spot?
That's a knot hole. I gotta warn Mark.
Oh, I wouldn't, Robin. If you're wrong, you could ruin your friendship with Mark. There's just so much dirt in the world.
Hey, people.
Mark, I have got to talk to you about your girl.
Yeah, my girl.
Robin.
I'll be cool. Mark, she's doing it to you all over again, and I cannot stand by and watch her break your heart.
That's not gonna happen.
Now, what makes you so sure?
We're engaged.
You're engaged?
Yep.
Dang! To Paula?
Yep.
Dang! Listen, now, Mark, you sure you're not moving too fast here?
You gotta remember, me and Paula were already together for 2 years.
Well, that's true.
And you spent one of those fighting.
Yeah, and the other one making up. Boy, that was a good year.
That's what I'm talking about. It was either fighting or loving with you two, high or low, with nothing in between.
Which is why we gotta get married. Like Paula says, to make a relationship like ours work, we need a commitment.
That is real romantic, Mark.
Oh. Yeah? You want romance? Wait till you see that engagement ring.
You got her a ring?
Yeah, I will after 200 easy payments. But look at the one she got me.
Oh, that's exquisite.
Cracker Jacks.
Mark, are you sure you're doing the right thing here?
Yes, I'm sure. I love Paula, and I don't want to risk losing her again.
Well, then congratulations.
Thank you.
Oh, congratulations, my eye. There is no way, no how, on God's good green earth, I'm going to stand by and let you go.
I think I speak for Robin when I say we're both very...
Ow, did you bite me?
Come on, Robin. I know you're looking out for me, so give Paula a chance.
You left teeth marks.
No, look, she's coming over Saturday night. And she's changed. You'll see for yourself.
Yeah, I don't know about that.
No, come on now. No, if the tables will turn, I'll do the same thing for you. Come on. Come on.
Careful, she bites.
All right, stop it. I will be there.
You gonna be nice? I'm gonna get them feet.
All right, no. Okay.
Bonjour. Hey. Mr. Cooper, that is a nice suit.
I don't want to brag, but it's the same brand that Pat Riley wears.
You get a raise or something?
No, actually, it was a gift from my fiancé.
Fiancé? Wow. You're really in love, aren't you, Mr. Cooper?
Yeah, I admit, I'm sprung. She's the most incredible woman I've ever known. Mm.
Why can't you boneheads be sweet like that?
All right. Break it up. Let's see the fruits of your creativity. Who's got something here? What you got there? Is this a car? Okay. All right. That's not bad. Not bad. Keep working on it. What you got there, man? What is this? Oh, hey, that's a frame. Don't put your picture in it. All right, a spice rack? Okay, there you go. Got to put it back on there. It'll fall out. Now, what do you have, Irvin?
Here.
Man, not another cutting board.
No, man, see, look. This side is a cutting board. This side is a cheese tray. That's creative, isn't it?
Man, you are so creative. Oh, man. Right. I tell you what, I got a new project for you.
Go ahead.
I want you to go home and explain the F I'm gonna give you to your father, okay?
F?
Yeah. Amanda, what do you have for us today?
Well, here's mine. Clocks. They're for my sister's birthday.
Now, this is ambitious. Man, your sister got a big old foot. God, but, ooh, this is kind of rough inside. You know you got a nail in there, too.
I hate my sister.
Ooh, there you go, Carrie. Anybody else got something?
Yeah, I just got a job.
What?
Yeah, I took your advice. I went down to Anderson's Furniture, showed them what I can do, and they hired me on the spot. And it's all because of you, Mr. Cooper.
See, this is what teaching is all about. See, from education back with some determination, you can do whatever you want to do. So what they got you doing at Anderson's? A little finishing, a little rough work, what?
Bookkeeping. No, I'm good at math. I stink at wood.
Right, but you learned that in my class, right? Go make you a calculator, boy.
Crowded, really. You ever seen somebody use coupons to buy a blouse?
Hey, wait a minute. I spent all day straightening up. You guys come in like a bunch of wild animals and flop down anywhere? That's not gonna happen today.
Excuse me?
And move these bags. Paula will be here any minute.
The man is cleaning.
Yes, I just want everything to be perfect. Now, this has not been a rough day for me. I've been slaving over a hot stove, the grocery store was a madhouse, and I've got cramps.
What?
In my fingers from chopping up so many vegetables.
The man is cooking, and he's wearing a coat and tie.
Well, like Paula says, a man should always dress to impress.
And you always do what Paula says.
I do not do what Paula says. Like Paula says, I am the man in the house. Oops, my cornbread is almost burning. Why don't you guys put on a little makeup? You look parched.
Can you believe how she's got him acting?
Yeah, it's a miracle.
What?
I mean, Robin, look at him. He's cooking, he's dressing better than ever. And did you notice he did not scratch himself once while we were talking to him?
Yeah, I know, but that is not my mark. My mark scratches.
What's wrong with giving the man a little polish? I mean, it's not like she's trying to run his life or anything.
I just do not like her or what she's doing to him.
You said you were going to be nice when Paula came.
Yeah, well, she's not here yet.
Nice time.
I'll be nice. See how nice. Paula, it's nice to see you.
Really?
Oh, sure enough, girl. Come on in here and sit on down.
Really? Come on, it's okay. Have a seat.
Hey, baby. I watched you on the news today. You were on right after Oprah. You know how I watch Oprah.
I missed you.
Me too. Why don't you ladies chat among yourselves and I get some hors d'oeuvres? Mm, mm,
mm. You are so good to me.
Mm-hmm. And when I'm bad, I'm even better.
Well, congratulations on the engagement. Oh, Mark has never been happier.
You know, that's true. Congratulations. It's okay.
You know what? I'm really glad you feel that way because you're very special to Mark, and Mark's very special to me. He's the sweetest man I've ever known.
You really do love him, don't you?
Oh, yes. I mean, you know, that's why I came back. You guys have all been out there. It's hard to find a man like Mark, a man with potential, man you could work with.
Work with?
You know, a man willing to let you mold him into something outstanding.
Oh, I understand. A man who needs you to run his life. Am I right?
Yes, girl, and what man doesn't?
Well, I like to think of it as navigating. You know, the trick is to bring him around slowly.
Yes, and you have done such a wonderful job so far.
And what else you got in mind?
Oh, a lot of things.
Oh, do tell.
Please, Shane.
Well, the big one's gonna take some time, but I've got a plan. I want to get Mark into something with more of a future.
Really? Like what?
Well, I've pretty much secured him a job at my station in the sales department.
Sales? Ooh, now doesn't that sound just like Mark?
Great idea, because you know Mark is pretty much on a dead-end career track. I mean, substitute teaching, that's just one notch above being a secretary, right?
Right!
I'm a secretary! and you, you're a really...
Tell her, B, tell her, tell her.
Bad anchor woman!
Yeah, that's telling her, V.
Here you go, chitlin pate.
Mark, she wants you to take some stupid job in sales and give up teaching.
Hmm? Baby, you do?
Oh, of course not, honey. If you want to be a teacher, I'm behind you 100%.
Fibber!
Just take it easy, dude. You're gonna hurt yourself.
Now, will somebody tell me what's going on here?
Look, this is not the time or the place to talk about this.
Oh, I think it's the time. Oh, and definitely the place.
You too. Can I talk to Paula alone for a minute?
Well, okay, but if you need us, we're gonna be right in there, okay?
Mm-hmm. Okay. I can't believe I hugged her.
Ugh. Now, Paula, what is this about a job?
Nothing.
Paula?
Well, there's this opening at the station in the sales department, and I just thought you'd be perfect for it.
But I thought I'm perfect for teaching.
I think so, too.
Now, what if I said I'm not gonna take that other job? You'd be okay with that, right?
Of course. For now.
What if I said I'm gonna teach for the rest of my life? You'd be okay with that, too, right?
Mark, I'm just thinking about our future.
But you'd be okay with that, right?
I just think that you can do better.
You're not gonna give me that okay, are you?
Mark, I really think that you need to keep an open mind about this.
Look, I've made up my mind. That's the reason I came back to Oakland, is to help kids.
Then be a scoutmaster. You're never gonna make any money being a teacher. You're just wasting your life.
What?
Look, honey.
Wait a minute. You still don't think I'm good enough for you, do you? Robin was right.
Why are you listening to them? They're just trying to come between us. Robin's hated me ever since the first time we broke up. And Vanessa, what does she know? She's a secretary.
Wait a minute. Wait. Why do you get off talking about my friends like that? You know what? This time, I'm dropping you.
Well, can't we just talk about this?
I don't think so. You know, I like who I am, and I'm not gonna change for you or nobody else. And you can take this ring. I'll mail it to you. You guys can come out.
Sorry, Mark.
Yeah. I can't believe I let her play me like that.
I can. You in love with the girl.
Yeah, I still am.
You know what? Believe this or not, I really wish I wouldn't have been right. Mm. Is there anything we can do for you?
Nah, I'll just sit here and be miserable, watch TV.
Well, you want some company?
Yeah, I don't mind. Why don't you put the tape in?
Oh, sure. This one here?
Yeah.
What is it?
Oprah.
Mark, that was good. Mm-hmm. I tell you what, let's shoot and see who cleans up.
All right, I'll go first.
Go ahead.
Okay.
Hey, I wouldn't want to be Cooper right now because that sink is overflowing with dishes. Hey, Jim, you know what? You're right, because the Coop man just hasn't been himself lately. Hey, Paula, how you doing?
Hey, that's no fair now.
Well, that's okay, because Coop Man, here's always next season.
I've never seen an announcer do like this before.
But he's very cool now. All right.